the First Lady of Physics, the Queen of Nuclear Research, the Chinese Madame Curie. These are all titles given to the scientist Qian Xiongwu, but what did she do to earn them?
Fu was born in eastern China on the 31st of May 1912, when girls were not expected to attend school.
Her father disagreed and founded a girls' school where Wu received her education.
She pursued maths and physics at the prestigious Nanjing University and moved to America to achieve a physics PhD.
She worked on the Manhattan Project, which was set up by Albert Einstein and Enrico Fermi to develop an atomic bomb. She proved her scientific capabilities by enhancing uranium ore for fueling the bomb.
When problems with the reactor arose, she was instrumental in finding the cause to be poisoning by the isotope xenon 135. She also helped Fermi by confirming his theory of beta decay.
Wu eventually fulfilled her dream of being a professor. Her students nicknamed her the Dragon Lady.
Fu's greatest work was disproving the law of conservation of parity. This is the theory that if something is mirrored, it will behave the same as if it existed in a mirror world.
Physicists Song Dao-li and Yang Chen-ning asked Wu to help experiment with the theory. She used near-zero temperatures on radioactive cobalt to find beta particles were emitted asymmetrically.
This disproved the parity theory, giving the first ever scientific definition of left and right and revolutionising the standard model.
Li and Yang won the Nobel Prize in 1957. However, Wu was excluded.
This treatment of women in science was apparent through her life, so she spoke out, saying, "I wonder whether the tiny atoms and nuclei, or the mathematical symbols, or the DNA molecules have any preference for either masculine or feminine treatment." She also faced racial discrimination, like the denial of a scholarship during her PhD.
Wu also contributed medically by researching sickle cell disease. She won the Wolf Prize and was the first living scientist to have an asteroid named after her, yet sadly today she is not remembered.